Hey, it's John, an enduring charm. This, or what's left of this, is a gable end vent that I removed from a customer's house just recently. And it's made of wood, and it's pretty badly deteriorated here. There's really nothing much left of it. So it's trashed, right? Time to get a new one. Except that it's not that easy to get a new one of this size and in wood. Probably I could special order it, but I'm really not going to wait weeks for that to happen, and God knows what it would cost. So instead of all that, we're going to see if we could just either repair what's left of this or just make an entirely new one if I have to. This is really not much to this. So they have these sides right here, which are normally nailed. I remove those nails to the side of the house, so it goes like that. And then this middle section here where the vent is, you have these louvers right here. This one's in all right shape. All the rest have been chewed by animals, I think. And you have just a frame. These louvers are let into the sides of that frame, probably at a 45 degree angle, it looks like. So not much to it, but this one's a mess. So let's see if we can make something new out of this so I can reinstall it. First thing I want to do is just get rid of this stuff that I know I'm not going to reuse, like this. And all this stuff is really easy to remake. So really it's just the sides here. I just want to see if there's anything left that I can reuse or if I just have to use it as a template. It's not in great shape. We have some screen on the back here. Let me get rid of that. That looks like that was put on as an afterthought. And well, I can really just pull this apart. These come out pretty easily. They were stapled in originally. This is nothing special. It's not antique or anything. It's probably put in the 1980s, something like that. Well, I might be able to save these sides if I'm careful here. This last one, I'll be careful. There's not much left of this. There. All right, so you can see these sides, they're not in great shape, but I can probably reuse them. You don't need a lot of structural. Man, it's pretty thin stuff. I think I can probably reuse that. So I'm going to see if we can take some of these louvers here and make some new ones. These are very thin. I'll have to measure it, but it looks not much more than 1/4 inch. All right, looks like our new louvers are going to fit pretty well. Now this old wood right here, you know, it's seen better days. So I'm going to use this stuff. You've seen me use this many times before, which just helps soak in and kind of consolidate. It's not rotted. There's no rot here, but it is just old wood. And this will help give it a little bit of strength and just keep it from rotting in the future, coming apart, and it'll take the paint a little bit better as well. So I'm just going to let that soak in. It dries very quickly. Now I'm just going to glue these together. I would normally use staples on the outside, but this stuff is so fragile that I'm a little bit afraid the staples will just blow right through. So glue will be just fine. And I may use some staples on the bottom. And we'll just go right down the line here doing all of these. That way I can separate them and then push it back together when I'm near the end there. All right, that's all glued up and clamped up. Just get some of this excess glue off of here. And I do want to check one more time about getting this square, so the check the diagonals to make sure that's good. And I may put a few staples in here just to hold it in place. Now there's a place right here, this area right here, and right here too, where some wood was chipped away. I will use filler to get rid of that whole area right there, not a big deal. And remember, we have the side pieces that go around that, so a lot of that will get covered anyway. So the old trim around the outside of the assembly is very simple. It's just a square cut, and they made a rabbet here on the inside edge, I should say, so that it overlaps the rest of the assembly. So I'm just going to duplicate that, and I have some old framing lumber. It's Doug fir, but perfectly useful for this purpose, and I will recut this on the table saw and then put it through the planer. All right, that's it for construction, and I reused one of the louvers. All the others are new, and we have this frame around it. Now, when the glue dries, I will sand this down and fill in any, you know, imperfections, the nail holes, all that, and then we'll get a primer coat and two finish coats of paint. But other than that, we're all set, all done. So, you know, the time it takes to rebuild this, it's really not that bad versus buying a new one, so I'm glad I went through the effort.